What up, YouTube? Bull15243. Doing another Yu-Gi-Oh! Related video. This time we're going to be doing Dueling Network. If you want to know my username on Dueling Network, it's the just the same as my YouTube username, Bull15243. Just look for that and you'll find me. But anyway, getting to the chase here. I don't know if... we'll see what I could do about that, but... Anyway, we're going to be doing a deck profile. So, we're going to be doing Utopia, my version of Utopia. Unlike Tech Guy A94's Utopia, but... Anyway, let's get to it. Sorry if the lighting's bad. You know, like the iPhone don't focus on me, but there's the deck. I'll zoom in on it so you can actually see it better. So for the main deck, it's a 40-card deck, if you can see it. So here's the monsters. Battling Box of the Hell. Two Goblin Bears. I used to have another one, but I replaced it with this guy because its ability, when you take battle damage, you gain a special sign and you gain those sleep on the back. This guy obviously knows what it does thanks to Tech Guy A94. Alright, Challenger, Assault, Cannon Blade, or Hellblade, whatever. Basically, when you can special summon this from your hand if you control no monsters in your opponent's control one, it's like that Cyber Dragon card. But it also does a bit better, because if this monster attacks a defense position monster, you can inflict piercing damage. So that's one good news. And the other good effect is that you get add an heroic mock card from your deck, which I only have these guys times 3, so another one. Okay, moving on. Photon Thrasher. Basically just special summon him if you control no monsters in your and but here's the negative effect to this. Cannot be normal summon or set. And if you control another monster, discard, cannot attack, so but whatever, I just go into the exceeds with him. 3 Secret Crane. Just like the deck guy has, but he has 2 because he only has 2 right now. 3 Star Drawings, you know what this guy does. 2 Summon Monk, it's at 2. 3 Tin Goldfish, you guys know what this does. Next up, ZWs. I'm gonna run one copy of the Lightning Blade and the Turmoil Bringer. You guys should know what that does by now. 2 Instant Fusions. Get to a card a little bit later. Rank up Astral Force. Basically, rank. It has to be. Let's say you have Utopia rank 4. It has to be next rank. It has to be a rank 6. And I'll show you what I have in store for later with this one. Rank up Magic Variance Force. Basically, summon a Chaos or Chaos XYZ monster. And here's the cool ability that I just learned recently, and it was too stupid to realize. If your opponent controls a XE monster with an XE material, you can actually take one of their materials from that XE monster, which is pretty cool. Limited Variance Force, you should know what that does. 3 Quick Chaos Spell Cards. Basically, I just use this with to get my victory out during the battle phase when I summon them. 1 Rhoda, it's at 1, obviously. And I obviously, guys, you could tell that obviously you guys are saying, oh, you're going to be weak, we already know what this does, blah, blah, blah. Well, guess what? Start a challenge. Basically, each material that's an exceed material, the equal monster gains 600 times the material. So, for example, you have a victory out with 4 materials that's equals 52. But and if you have, for example, V with the same amount of materials, that's
Basically, you're just getting a hell of a lot of life points, but attack points, I mean. But at the end, you cannot use the effect that effect is negated, but when it inflicts battle damage, the damage is actually doubled. So if you have like those big, huge ass monsters on the field, it's like you're basically almost guaranteed to get game. Next up, 2XYZ Chaintastics. You should guys know what this does, and 3 Royal Decrees. Okay, now time for the extra deck.
I can hear what you're thinking. All your doubts and fear.
And if you okay, guys, I gotta get off now.